This is an equalizing beam suspension system that is extremely rare, even in high-priced flagship LEGO engineering sets. The key point is that the entire vehicle body can even be unfolded like this, or retracted like this. In addition, there is also the function of the tail panel lifting, the rotation of the crane, the lifting and lowering of the crane, the extension and retraction of the lifting hook, the opening and closing of the cabin door, and there are a whole bunch of other functions and ways to play. This is the LEGO 42180 Mars Crew Exploration Rover set, and it's also part of the same series as last year's 42181 Heavy Cargo Spaceship set. Through this video, let's take a look at its internal design and final assembled product's performance. This is the linkage structure of the lifting tail panel. The manual power enters from the gear knob on the right side, driving a 20-tooth gear through a worm. Then it is transmitted to both the left and right sides through a 4-to-4 gear set. And this in turn drives the parallelogram linkage rod. Because of the characteristic of one-way power transmission of the worm gear mechanism, the entire tail panel has load-bearing capacity throughout the entire process of lifting and lowering. The two rear axles of this exploration rover adopt a relatively rare equalizing beam-type suspension structure. When one of the wheels is lifted due to encountering an obstacle, the pressure will be transmitted to the other wheel through a seesaw structure above. But the designer didn't incorporate shock-absorbing components here, so it can be regarded as a simplified version of the design. In addition, we can also see that the designer has used a portal axle here to improve the passing performance of the exploration rover. However, in the position where the gears are supposed to be placed in the axle components, the designer didn't install any gears. So there are also no designs related to the differential or the linkage with the engine and other such features. Perhaps this also leaves more room for players to modify the model. The front suspension also adopts a solid axle suspension. After the manual steering power comes down from the roof of the vehicle, it reaches this blue steering gear through a 4-to-4 gear set, and then drives the wheels to turn through the steering tie rods. As can be seen here, the main body of the vehicle's chassis is divided into two large modules, the front and the rear. The designer has used the rack part numbered 18942 here as a sliding guide rail. In addition, the damping is adjusted by means of two 12-tooth gears and two 16-tooth gears. On the left side of the rear of the vehicle, you can see that the rotation of the crane uses a small turntable with 28 teeth, which is driven by a 12-tooth gear after the manual power is input. The power for the crane's lifting and lowering comes from the gear knob on the side. It drives a small push rod through a 12-to-12 gear set to control the crane's lifting and lowering. The rotation points of the two crane booms both adopt a very simple friction pin scheme. Additionally, we can also observe a manual winch structure here. Well, it took approximately 7 or 8 hours and this Mars Crew Exploration Rover was finally completed. The final assembled product, when unfolded, it has a length of 50 centimeters. And if it is folded up, it is approximately 34 centimeters in length. This vehicle doesn't have a specific physical prototype. Instead, it is a work that takes the NASA Mars Exploration Concept Vehicle as the design inspiration and undergoes secondary creation. Except for the orange crew cabin in the middle, not many technical panels are used in other parts. Overall, it still looks relatively abstract. Inside the cockpit, we can see the blue driver's and co-driver's seats, as well as the dashboard constructed with blue transparent parts. Moreover, this dashboard is also a printed component. Outside the orange cabin behind the cockpit, we can see the satellite antenna and some external devices that might be pressure tanks or the like. Then further to the rear is the cargo platform. Here, we can see that in addition to the crane, there are some items such as what might be fuel tanks, or boxes, signal beacons, fuel cells, and even an unmanned vehicle. These are all tools and equipment for Mars exploration. In terms of functions, there is the driving and steering of the vehicle. Since it is a static version and there is no linkage between the engine and the gearbox, it will definitely move very smoothly when pushed. In addition, by turning the steering gear knob on the roof, the steering is also very flexible. Well, due to the suspension structure that was explained during the evaluation process, the entire vehicle indeed has a very good twisting amplitude in the finished product stage. Its off-road passing performance should also be quite good, but it doesn't really make much sense for the static version. In terms of other functions, it includes that the entire cockpit can be opened forward. The crew cabin in the middle can be opened to both sides. And there is also a tailgate that can be lifted up. Inside the crew cabin, you can see small details such as seats, cabinets, a treadmill, and what might be a toilet, among other things. By turning the gear knob on the right side of the vehicle's rear, you can load and unload supplies through the tailgate. There is also the rotation of the crane, and the lifting and lowering of the crane, and the winding and unwinding of the winch. All these functions have been tested and there are no problems with them. On both sides of the vehicle body, we can see that there is a yellow module on each side. If we pull it out, then we can fold up the entire vehicle. Correspondingly, we need to fold up the cargo platform's material fence first. Finally, insert the yellow module back. That's roughly the operation steps. Everyone can probably feel that this is indeed a Technic set that leans more towards being fun to play with on the ground. Relatively speaking, it also places more emphasis on the quantity of functions. Except that the suspension design is relatively innovative, all other functions are still very simple. Overall, it is a set that is quite suitable for new players. Okay then, let's take a look at the packaging in the end. The front of the color box features a scene of Mars exploration. It is targeted at those aged 11 and above. On the back of the color box, there are a large number of functional diagrams. After opening the packaging, the 1,599 parts are divided into 13 large step sub-packages in total. In addition to a sticker like this one, the assembly manual is placed in a craft paper bag. There are a total of 418 steps, with an average of 3.8 parts per step. At the end of the manual, there are two pages of color illustrations. However, basically they are just a reese of the front and back images of the color box. In addition, there is also a collective display of all the sets in the Space series. That's all for this review. See you guys!